So in a previous presentation, we looked at installing the boxes onto the wooden board using countersunk screws, making sure they're level with an even gap. Now we're going to continue on the first fix by introducing the cables. Our cables have been used before, therefore we've got to have a little bit of extra work in order to get them nice and flat and smooth before we start. And then we're going to secure them to the wooden board. This is the first time we've clipped any cables, so it's the basic techniques required to bend and clip PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables. Or PVC twin and earth if you're on site. We're going to start off accessory number one. Accessory number one is going to be simulating a lighting point, and that lighting point is going to be wired in 1mm² PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, simulating a switching line and neutral going to that accessory. Often on site, 1.5mm² cable is used because of the amount of thermal insulation used in domestic dwellings. Before we start, we've got the cable, and it could have been that it's hung through a ceiling void or been placed through a floor and there's kinks and bumps in it, no different to our cable, which is second hand. So before doing anything with it, I need to run my hands through the cable in order to remove as many of the bumps that I can before starting the dressing process. So two or three times through with my hands to get it a little bit smoother before I do the following. Take my cable now, and I'm going to hold it onto the board, and I'm going to drag against the board. So if I hold it onto the board, I'm going to take my four fingers and put them underneath the cable, and my thumb on the top, and I'm going to pull against the cable, against the surface. Okay, ours is a wooden surface. It could be a brick or block surface. In order to get it to, not stick necessarily, but lay flat right against the surface itself. So four fingers on the bottom, thumb on the top, hold it at the top to move my arms out of the way for the demonstration, and just drag against the actual board itself. And we're going to do that several times. The full length of the cable for me. And if I hold it top and bottom now, hopefully you can see that that's fairly flat to the surface of which we're working with. I'll do it again. Four fingers underneath, thumb on the top, and drag against the board itself. So I've got my cable dressed and reasonably flat against the surface, in this case a wooden surface. For my exercise, I'm going to need to put a 90 degree bend in at the top. At the moment, being the first time we've ever clipped PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables to a surface, I just want a nice smooth bend. We'll cover the bending radius and acceptable bending radiuses in a later presentation. So just make sure it's nice and flat and look at doing this smooth bend. I'm going to take my fingers, and they're going to be on the outside, and my thumbs are going to be on the inside for this. So somewhere near the top of the cable, leaving me plenty to go down into the accessory. I'm going to take my fingers on the outside, my thumbs on the inside, and I'm going to pull once, and then move my thumbs up slightly, again and move my thumbs again. So I've pulled it in about three positions in order to get hopefully a smooth 90 degree bend, which we can still work on. Back on the board, I'm going to drag it again against the board, making sure it's super flat. I'm just going to check my 90 degree. I'm happy with that. I'm now ready to put it into the actual accessory box itself. So I can go down into the box, and I'm going to position it so the bend for my exercise is reasonably close to the top, giving us the maximum amount of clipping on this wooden surface, but we've now got to get it straight and clipped appropriately with our nice smooth bend. So let's have a look at the clipping process next. So my cable is now into the accessory. I've got a smooth 90 degree bend on it, and I'm trying to get it straight into my accessory itself. So in order to make some adjustments, I'm not going to fully put my clips in just yet. I'm just going to pin them into position. The clips are PVC, PVC, 1mm² clips, okay, and they're grey, the same as the cable itself. So just get it into position, just take a few moments. I like my clips to support across the bend, not actually on the bend, but the first straight point either side of the bend would be my clipping position. And I also like my nails to run in the appropriate order. So at the moment, just pinning it into position so I can make adjustments if I need to. Equal distance across the bend on the other side. So if I was to split the middle of that bend, the clip would be even distance this way and even distance that way. Okay, I can make a small adjustment if I'm not happy with my bend. And put the clip back in, which would be about, just about there. Now I'm looking to come down straight into the accessory. So have I got to make any adjustments? Does it come down straight? Sometimes thrown off by the wooden board line, but I'm going to make sure it looks as straight as I possibly can. And my last clip is going to go within about 15 to 20 mil of my accessory itself. Not too close, because obviously if I miss and hit the box, there is a chance I'll break it. So we're just checking that, and we'll pin that one in place. Okay. If I'm happy with those, I could leave them. Or if I wasn't happy, I could just take out the clip, wiggle it out with my fingers and adjust its position, move it over, or back, okay? So not at this stage, I'm not hammering them into the wooden board because adjustments would be very difficult. I step back and have a look. Am I happy? Is it straight with a nice smooth bend? If the answer is yes, then we can go with that. That clipping distance there at the moment is just one that we're presuming. Again, we haven't looked in the regulations for the maximum clipping distances. But because this is our first exercise, we're probably going to halve the distance. I like that distance for a clipping distance. This is a first practice exercise to help us get it a lot straighter. We're going to put one in the middle of that position. Just take my tape measure and measure between the center of the two clip positions, so the middle of the clips, and then I halve that. So I am going to be about 18 centimeters or 180 mil. And again, drop the clip in. And again, I check it before I do anything else. I just pulled it slightly across there to make sure we are straight down. Again, pin it. I like the nails to run up the inside and follow it round the inside of the bend, and if we carried on, would keep going. Okay, I haven't got the nail on this left-hand side for me, obviously right-hand side for you. Look, I've got the nails running up the inside and round of the cable. I prefer that for supporting the cable, especially where we go horizontally. If I'm happy with it at this stage, I can now put them in. But before we bang those clips home, we must remember to wear goggles. It says on most of the boxes of clips that goggles should be worn because these nails can shatter, especially where we're clipping them into the course of brickwork. So we're gonna make sure our goggles are on, and now we can send home these clips if we're happy with them. And at that stage, hopefully, we've got the cable coming straight into accessory with a nice smooth bend. So we've completed the first fix for stage one. We've installed the box, we've dressed the cable, cable's flat to the surface, and the clips for me at college are positioned so the nails run up the inside and round so we support it horizontally. It's nice and flat to the surface, it's got a smooth 90 degree bend. Possibly the centre clip in the real world wouldn't be needed. We've added it in because this is the first time we're clipping PVC, 20cc cables to any surface. So I expect it to be flat with a smooth bend and straight on the surface that we've chosen, in this case, a wooden board. So that's the basic clipping process that we're going to use here at college in order that we install our cables correctly to, in this case, a wooden surface.